Hi kids, how are you all? I hope you all must be fine. Yes. So today we are going to read about the science Olympiad for class 4. So what chapter we are going to read here? We have already started the chapter, that is animal life, and today we are going to discuss some more questions of this chapter. Okay. So are you all ready for it? Yes. So let's start. So what is our first question? Study the following diagram. Frogs and salamanders can be placed in which part of the above diagram? So here we have frogs and salamanders, and where should we keep them? Okay, so this circle, it is for terrestrial animals, this is for aquatic, and this is for aerial. Now we know that the frogs and salamanders, these are amphibians. Yes, these are amphibians. That means they live both on land and in water. So we can tell them as terrestrial and also aquatic. So terrestrial and aquatic, so it would be X, right? So what is the correct answer here? Here correct answer is option B, X. Got it everyone? Let's move to the next question. An animal is taken to the polar region. Which of the following adaptive characteristics may help it survive in new environment? Option A, growth of thick and less hairy skin. Option B, sharp beaks and strong claws. Option C, growth of thick fur on its skin. Option D, lightweight wings to fly. So what is the question given here? An animal, it is taken to the polar region. Okay. And you know in polar region, it is too cold, right? So which of the following adaptive characteristic they should adapt so that they can survive in that cold polar region? So what may be the answer? Yes, if you know the answer, you can definitely write in the chat box. Yes, you can write in the comment section. So yes, it is option C, that is growth of thick fur on its skin. So growth of thick fur on the skin, it helps them to survive in the cold regions. Okay. Now, what is our next question? The next question is, a student identified the following characteristics in an animal. Strong claws and broad hip girdles, spines to prevent from slipping, ability to climb trees. So, which of the following title describes the above characteristics? Okay, A, terrestrial animal, B, aquatic animal, C, amphibian animal, D, arboreal animal. So, what are the characteristics of the animal? It is having strong claws and broad hip girdles, then spines to prevent from slipping and ability to climb trees. So, what may be the answer here? Yes, so ability to climb trees, we know that it is for arboreal animals, right? So, what is the correct answer here? Here, the correct answer is option D, that is arboreal animals. Okay, now let's move to the next question. What is the question here? Which of the following animals is incorrectly matched to it? It's adaptation. So animals are given, adaptations are given. Okay, so polar bear, thick coat of fur, opossum, broad feet, snowy owl, thick coat of feathers, then monkey, long limbs and tail. So polar bear, it is having thick coat of fur. Yes, it is correct, because to survive in cold, they need thick coat of fur, right? And for opossum, broad feet, is it students? No, it's not true. So what happens here? It has sharp claws. It does not have broad feet. Okay, so this one is not correct. Snowy owl, thick coat of feathers. Yes, it is also correct. Monkey, we know monkeys have long limbs and tail, right? Yes. So what is the incorrect answer? Opossum and broad feet, it is the incorrect answer. But for us, it is the correct answer. Right, that is option B. Now let's move to the next question. Which of the following animals have long sticky tongues? Option A, cows, B, eagles, C, chameleon, D, cheetahs. So which of the following animal have long sticky tongues? Any guesses? Yes, what may be the answer? Yes, you all know that is chameleon. So here the correct answer is option C, chameleon, because it have long sticky tongues. Okay, let's move to the next question. Which of the following is not an adaptation for self protection of, from predators? Okay, option A, migration, B, change in color, C, moving in groups, D, bearing eye-like patterns. So, which of the following is not an adaptation for self-protection from predators? Okay, so we know that animals, they always try to protect themselves from the predators, right? So, what is not included in this adaptation? So, migration, is it? No, because in migration they try to adapt with the climate. Okay, so they move from one place to another place for adaptation with the climate, not from predators. Okay, changing color, yes, it is correct. They change the color. Also, they move in groups, right? Then bearing eye-like patterns, yes, this is also correct. So which one is not correct? That is option A, migration. Got it? So here the correct answer is option A, migration. Now let's move to the next question. Which of the following body parts maintain balance in a monkey? So options are A, tail, B, neck, C, legs, D, abdomen. So which of the following body parts maintain balance in monkeys? So all of you must have seen monkeys, right? Yes. So how it maintains its balance? Yes. It maintains its balance by this tail, right? So that's why here the correct answer is option A, tail. Yes, got it? Now, which of the following give birth to babies? Snakes, cockroach, lion or butterfly? Yes, you all must be having idea, right? So what is the answer here? Yes. The answer is option B, lion. We know that lions, these are mammals, okay? So what they do, they give birth to babies and they feed milk to the babies, okay? Yes. Then what is our next question? Which of the following life cycle is correct? Option A, baby, teenager, child, adult. Option B, seed, flower, plant, fruit. Option C, cocoon, larva, egg, adult. Option D, eggs, caterpillar, pupa and butterfly. So what is the correct answer? Can anyone guess? Yes. Baby, teenager, child, adult. No, it is not correct. Seed, flower, plant, fruit. No, it is also not correct. Cocoon, larva, egg, adult. No, it is also not correct. Eggs, caterpillar, pupa, butterfly. Yes, this one is the correct one. Okay, so here the correct life cycle, that is option D, eggs, then caterpillar, then pupa, then butterfly, right? Okay, now next option, what does an egg yolk contain? Option A, water, B, stored food, C, soil, D, sunlight. What do you think? Okay, you tell me, do you like egg? Yes or no? Yes? Okay, so egg yolk, what does it contain? Does it contain water? No. Does it contain soil? No. Sunlight? No. It contains stored food. Okay. It contains stored food for the embryo. So here the correct answer is option A. Option B, that is stored food. Got it? Now let's move to the next question. Dolphin is a mammal, an amphibian, a fish, an egg-lying fish. Okay, so what is the correct answer? Yes, correct answer is dolphin is a mammal. So what do you mean by mammal? So mammals, they usually they have a gland, that is mammary gland. That's why we call them as mammal. So mammary gland, that is milk producing gland. So what they do, they feed their babies with milk. Okay, that's why they are known as mammals. So dolphin is a mammal. So here the correct answer is option A, that is mammal. Okay, now what is the next question? Tadpole resemble A, frogs, B, eggs, C, fish, D, cocoons. So have you ever seen these tadpoles? Yes, have you ever seen? Okay, so what does it resemble? Yes, it resembles fish. Okay, so here the correct answer is option C, that is fees. Got it? Now coming to the next question, which of the following is possessed by a tadpole but not by an adult frog? Yes, option A, eye; B, tail; C, kidney; D, lungs. What is the correct answer? Yes, tadpole, you know that is larva of frog, right? So that it contains tail, but this adult frog, it does not contain tail, right? So the correct answer is option B, that is tail, possessed by the tadpole but not by adult frog. Okay, yes, next question. The diagram given below illustrates the process of, yes, nymph, that is going to be cockroach. So nymph and cockroach, and how it is going to be cockroach? By shedding its skin. So what is the name of the process? Okay, option A, molting; B, reproduction; C, life cycle; D, food chain. So we have to find out the name of the process in which a nymph is converted to cockroach by shedding the skin. Okay, so name of the process, that is option A, molting. Got it? Yes. So coming to the last question of today's class, a student observed that birds sit on their eggs before the eggs are hatched into young ones. The reason is option A, to protect the egg; B, to keep the egg warm so that it hatched; C, to hide the egg from others; D, it is customary for the birds to sit on the eggs. Okay, so have you ever noticed these things, like egg is there and a bird is sitting on the egg? Have you noticed? You must not, right? Okay, may some of you may have noticed it. So what is the student is observing? The birds sit on their eggs before the eggs are hatched into young ones. So why the birds sit they on their eggs? Yes, to keep the egg warm. So if the egg will be warm, then it can be hatched. Okay, so here the correct answer is option B, to keep the egg warm so that it hatched. Got it, everyone? Yes. Okay, so this much for today's class, and let's meet you in next class, and till then keep learning. Okay, and let's meet you in the next class with some much more amazing question of this chapter. Okay, till then read mindfully. Bye bye everyone. Bye bye.